The topic that I am focusing now in this 12 minutes, inshallah, will be the institutional Jamal. Jamal, the institutional, the institution building and developer. He has established directly or indirectly many institutions. In fact, Sheikh Taha, Allah yarhamu, once listed 32 such institutions. Now, to comment on all those, it will take 32 hours, but alhamdulillah, there are other panelists who will share these and explain and expand on these some of these institutions. Still, not all of them, but some of them. The basis, foundation for the philosophy of Jamal, Allah yarhamu, in established institutions were three. Number one, we should not be doing what we can do, but we must be doing what must be done. We should not be like the water which goes around and fills the valleys and the swamps and the holes. We should be seeking higher grounds. That's what the launching pad of always Jamal, whenever you see him. Number two, we have to do what others cannot do. And that is the objective that he set for him and for us. Number three, establish institutions, and when they are standing on their own feet, give them or hand them over to the next generation who have been trained and are dedicated, and they will have their own creativities and initiatives to carry them further and higher up. So these, on these three basic principles that Jamal, rahmatullah alayh, started early in his life of establishing and building institutions. To accomplish all this, he realized in 1955 that to do this when he is 18 years old, he needs to establish a team, because he cannot do it alone. It's not possible. Now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave me the opportunity and the blessings to introduce him to the activism and dynamism of Islamic world. And alhamdulillah, this whole journey of 60 years culminated in the establishment of the IIIT, International Institute of Islamic Thought. So this is the context that enabled Jamal, rahmatullah, to excel and produce abundantly many institutions that we all enjoy and practice, alhamdulillah. There is a saying, a commercial, some of you may remember, that you cannot take about a cigarette, Marlboro. You cannot take Marlboro out of the country. You can take Marlboro out of the country, but you cannot take the country out of Marlboro. You cannot take institution out of Jamal, but you can take the institution, Jamal, out of the institutions. So that was his actually essence. He was always institutional, mashallah. It all started building the first institution when we were in London in 1959. And we visited the Islamic Center in Baker Street in London, mosque. It was a huge, monumental mosque building. We used to have Saturday Quranic study in the afternoon. And one day we went down to the basement and we saw lots of things full with a lot of dust. Nobody has touched them for years. So we moved a few papers, cleaned them, and then we see some flyers written by Hassan al-Turabi, Usama Muhammad Ali, Abdul Sahib Hassan, people from Iraq and so on, engineers. And when we looked at them, we realized that, where are these people? They are no more, they have left. They did a lot of work, but when they left, that the work is gone. So we got this idea that in order to have continuity and stability, you need to build institutions. So we built the first institution in 1960, MSS, Muslim Student Society of the United Kingdom and Northern Ireland, where we have a camp in a zawiya, or a simple mosque, small mosque at that time, and for between Christmas and the New Year, for 1 week, we have very active program. And this thing, alhamdulillah, flourished and grew because of the right principles that it had. Openness, inclusiveness, non-sectarian, non-political, includes both men and women, all this kind of democracy, election, shura, and so on. And we left it in 1962 when we went back to Iraq, Jamal and I, to Ahmed Tutinci, who continued in Birmingham. And actually, Ahmed Tutinci left 63 to here, Penn State, Pennsylvania State College, where he established with Ahmed Sakhar and others MSA. In fact, MSA is the daughter of MSS. Why? Because of those good principles that were established on. And when you have an organization, no matter how small, if you have the right concepts, principles, practice, it will always grow up. And this is exactly what happened. Now, the daughter of MSS, MSA, has become the mother of so many good organizations. One of them is this IIIT, is the daughter of the MSA, walhamdulillah. There was a story in 1972. There was a Jami Mosque in Toronto, in Canada, and they had problems. And the owner of that mosque was a man and his wife, a Muslim man and his wife, and he locked, and they went to court and so on the premises, the Jami, the mosque. So we in the MSA were presented with this problem. What to do? Well, we collected, Rahmatullah Alayh, King Faisal, $130,000, and then we wanted to buy this mosque and give it to the community, but the owner didn't want to sell it to a Muslim. So we had to go to a Chinese non-Muslim to buy it and then assign it to the Muslim community. So we got the lesson, we need an institution to take care of our mosque and Islamic centers, which were flourishing up, going up one after the other. And that was the establishment of the Waqf, NAIT, North American Islamic Trust. And it grew up, mashallah, into more than 200 and 250 mosques in the name of Waqf, where the philosophy was simple. The community will buy the mosque or Islamic center, pay their money and so on, but register it in the name of the NAIT, and NAIT will have long lease with them, $1 a year, so that they can, so that NAIT will have the power. When this center goes astray, it will come back and repossess it and put it in the right direction. Now, as you heard also, in 1972, Jamal was one of the founders with Farouqi and Ahmed Tutinci and myself to establish the AMSS, Association of Muslim Social Scientists. Then, the idea of what should be done to continue and to establish the Islamic work in North America, several things came, four items. The most important one was we have to deal with the Islamic thought. The Islamic thought that exists today cannot be applied unless it has to be renewed. According to the hadith of Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, everyone under these, there Allah will send a reformer or a teacher or a scholar who will renew the religion for them. So we discussed this idea, and in 19 with Al-Farouqi and Abdul Hamid Abu Sulaiman and Jamal, and then in 1977 we convened an international scholarly seminar in Lugano, Switzerland, where several committees were established, and the most important decision was, or recommendation was, to establish an institute, academic, international, non-political, non-sectarian, not jihadist, but ijtihadist, okay? All this, democratic and so on. And this came to being in 1981, when we were in Riyadh at that time, actually, but then Abdul Hamid and Jamal, they came here with Al-Farouqi and they established officially and formally the International Institute of Islamic Thought. That says my 11 minutes are over, so I'll take maybe two more 3 minutes, okay? As I said, there are many institutions that Jamal contributed directly or indirectly. One of them with Dr. Abdul Hamid, you remember this IIUM, International Islamic University of Malaysia. They established this so-called IRKH. There is something important, which is the Islamic Revealed Knowledge and the Human Sciences, that Jamal was the dean of. It was like half of the university, actually, okay? But the point here is revealed knowledge, because in academia, revelation is not considered knowledge, okay? But Abdul Hamid insisted revealed knowledge is knowledge. And they had a lot of controversy and attacks, especially from seculars, as well as from academic academicians who are Muslims by name, but they still don't believe that, you know, this new idea is valid and so on. Now, in 1989, Jamal said that in a democratic country, we, the Muslim community, are weightless unless and until we start participating in the political process. And his brainchild, brain idea was to establish actually what is called AMC, American Muslim Council. And alhamdulillah, it did a lot of work. It put actually Muslims, Muslim community in the political arena. So many other things. Jamal, mashallah, contributed and established finally. We are all very grieved and sorry that we lost our brother, dear scholar and mentor, rahmatullahi alayhi, Dr. Jamal. But Allah is very kind. He did not leave us with nothing. He left us with the legacy of Jamal, the team that Jamal brought up and trained and worked with. And I still remember his famous saying that a good manager is the manager when he leaves, the people will do better than when he is in. So that's what Jamal rahmatullah did. I say, Allahumma la tahrimna ajrah wa la taftinna ba'dah. Oh Allah, do not deprive us of his rewards and do not test us of Jamal. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.